Peace, fam. Guido on the scene. Glad to see that the Afri-Cultivated community has grown dramatically as others continue to spread African knowledge throughout the community. If you want to link up, you can follow me on Twitter or Instagram, or we can have live discussions on Clubhouse about different perspectives of African and African-American history that's in question. The link will be in the description. Also, I'll start back producing our Afri-Culture hygiene products as soon as I can get 100 Afri-Cultivators to sign up to our new Afri-Culture Concepts mailing list so that you will be able to stay in the loop about new events, updates, and products. The link to our Afri-Culture email list is in the description as well. Go and click and just leave your email address. When it comes to Islam in West Africa, a lot of people tend to give all credit to the West African Fulbe or Fulani ethnic group that mostly became a people in the Futaturo region between southern Mauritania and northern Senegal. When discussing different histories, people tend to put events on either a person or a people that the figure emerged from. Perhaps giving credit to an individual is a lot more practical than just throwing names around that could possibly cause issues for people that may be ethnically associated with such, but has absolutely nothing to do with the event in discussion or even sharing ideology with the people that may have carried out this historical event. Like the Mende ethnic group of West Africa has several subgroups that have things in common and bind them together as a similar cluster based off of language, customs, and religion, or ETC. The Fulani ethnic group of West Africa displays the same ethnical diversity. Till this day, all Fulbe or Fulanis are not strictly Islamic. All Fulbe are not pastoralists, and all Fulanis do not share the same views. Depending on distance, if you get a Fulani from Senegal and a Fulani from Nigeria, they may not even be able to have a very smooth conversation in Pular because even their dialects differ from region to region. For example, a few names of Fulbe subgroups call themselves Wodabe Bororo, Jukun, Tiv, Chamba, Bamileke, Wurkun, Basherma, Jinja, etc. Some of these groups, although they may have some people that are Islamic, they are not known to be all strictly Islamic. Some fully Islamic, some only nominal Muslims, and some just practice pre-Islamic religion, period. So that leaves us to ask, which Fulbe clan was known for actually spreading, teaching, and forming more of a militant form of Islam in the region, you ask? Let's see what African Muslim scholar Abu Afa Muhammad Sharif Ibn Farid said. And I quote, "The Turube were distinguished from other Fulbe ethnicities due to the fact that they played a key role as leaders of religion and purveyors of intellectual and religious reform throughout the Western, Eastern, and Central Sudan." Olorantimihin states in his book called The Segu Tukulor Empire, page 11, quote, "The Turube are a subclan of the Tukulor inhabitants of Tekrur." He also points out that the Tukulors had a three-branch caste system. The Rimbe, or nobility, who included the Turube clan, the Sibbe, which we call the rulers, the Jamwambe, the political advisors, how do you pronounce this one group? The Sibibbe, which are the fishing lineage. Then you have the second tier caste, the Neimbe, the artisans, and then you have the Welibe, the smiths. Then you have the Sakibe, the griots, or oral historians. Then you have the Awilube, the chief dynastic griot, the Mahbube, the weaver griot, the Wambabe, the pastoral griot. And then you have the lowest caste, which was the Jayabe, the domestic servants, and the Makube, slaves. According to Jean Suret Canelli in his book, The Social and Historical Significance of the Pool Hegemonies of the 17th, 18th, and 19th Centuries, he says, "The Jianghanki held power and sway over the ancient homeland of the Fulbe in Futaturo from 1559 until 1776. The Jianghanki ruling class were also responsible for the massive sale of Muslim Fulbe to the Portuguese, Spanish, and other European powers." This short couple of scholarly references hold sway that all people under the banner of one ethnic group does not always share exact common interests. Where here, the fact is made obvious how the Jianhanke Fulbe did not share interests with the Turube line of Fulbe, and should explain which branch of the Fulbe Confederacy was actually responsible for the dissemination of Islam further east into the Western Sudan region of Africa. Most authors that focus on the Turube history give responsibility of spreading Islam to the Empire of Ouagadougou and other Sudanese states during this time. Ibn Farid even goes on to say that the Jianhanke were in fact the Sebe ruling class of the Tekrur. Prior to their suppressive wars against the Muslim scholar notables among the Turube, it is also known among educated Fulbe that the Turube clan was a mixed group of people that were not all ethnically pure Fulbe. Here are a few known West African icons that you may not have known that were Turube. Muhammad ibn Abu Bakr at-Turudi, known as Askia Muhammad, who led a rebellion against the Sonike and established an empire based on Islamic principles. Muhammad Sanu originally came from Bitu, south of Jinni, and he established a learning center which rivaled with the universities of Timbuktu. Muhammad Gidadu was appointed as the imam and the dean of Jingerber Masjid, the main masjid of Timbuktu. The Gidadibe, the family of Gidadu, not only helped diffuse Islamic learning amongst the Songhai, but also protected a commercial interest of families who had little or no standing among the commercial families of Timbuktu. Muhammad Girdo was the primary source of learning in Songhai during the 16th century. His father was Moody Muhammad Saj, the chief judge of Masina. Karamoko Alpha Ibrahima Sambega Bari of Futajalon. He established an Islamic confederation whose center was in Timbo. His confederation lasted until the French invasion of the 19th century. In 1760, as a result of repression from the Jianhanke rulers and the slave trade, the Turube organized themselves into a resistance movement led by Suleiman Ba. Abdul Qadir Khan opened the door of jihad among the Futankube, which means the people of Futa. Abdul Qadir was also to defeat the Moroccan slave raiders and gain allegiance with the Wolof, Jianhanke, and Wolof kings. Another notable Turube that happened to unwillingly make it to the American hemisphere was Amir Abu al-Hussein Abdurrahman ibn Ibrahim Asori of Futajalon, the region of West Africa. He was captured while he was commanding a 2,000-man army on the coast to protect and strengthen their economic interests in the region. He was sold to the French, who brought him to Natchez, Mississippi, where Abdurrahman was a slave for more than 38 years before he was freed. An excerpt from Robert Dannen's Black Pilgrimage to Islam, page 20, says, Upon his arrival in Washington, Ibrahima became a ward of the American Colonization Society, a Methodist-dominated organization that was planning to send missionaries to Africa. Ibrahima soon embarrassed his sponsors by stirring religious controversy everywhere. He relished the opportunity to question their form of Christianity by arguing with religious leaders of that time. In one religious debate, he stated, "I tell you, the testament very good law. You no follow it. You no pray often enough. You greedy after money. You want more land. You want more N-words. You make the N-word work hard. You make more cotton. Where you find that in your law?" Another Turube that was taken from Timbo in Futajalon in the 1780s. He was sold on the Bahamas, where he married the daughter of another Turube and had many children. Muhammadu Bilali, or better known as Bilali Muhammad, led the role that the Turube community played in the Revolutionary War of 1812. He swore to defend the island from British attack. He was the imam and emir of more than 81 Turube families. He composed a 13-page manual in Arabic for his Sapelo Island, Georgia Muslim community, the only known antebellum African Muslim community in the United States. I hope I was able to disseminate some understanding about ethnic and ideological diversity of the greater West and Central African populations and present a closer perspective of the linguistic, cultural, and ideological diversity within the Confederation of Fulbe or Fulani, and move the magnifying glass back a bit from the Fulanis as a whole when it comes to the dissemination of Islam. Attempt to refocus that lens until we get into the Turube clearly before we begin our magnification process, simply because that's what history has left us to know of. And I hope that my brief discussion of Turubes in the Americas on the American continent showed they were not only in Louisiana, like a dear brother stated to me the other day on a social media post, LOL. When the ops destroyed the Black Wall Street of Tulsa, Oklahoma, it was still dozens more Black Wall Streets all throughout the state. Hit the www.13blacktownstour.com link to take a tour of the last 13 towns now. If you see me on Clubhouse and you have any inquiries about this tour, don't hesitate to message me there or follow me on IG or Twitter. Those links are on my Clubhouse profile as well. Thanks for listening, fam. And remember, at the end of the day, we help people find natural hygiene solutions that restore melanin to its deep, illuminated, and moisturized state by returning cultural awareness to one's mind, the ideal place. Peace.